Are we back? Are we alive? Okay. I don't know. On my end, it said it was still fine, and then I was actually behind on chat, and I scrolled through, and I saw a million Fs. Like, a million of them. I'm like, oh, no. I was just responding to that message last week. But yeah, that's a two-party decision. But we'll see where I'm at that point, and we'll try and make it work. Cause I'd like to meet you. It'd be fun. I caught that one late because I was behind on chat answering a few questions, which you probably didn't hear because I was behind on chat answering questions when you guys were all saying F. F, 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 F. So I apologize. But that's happened a couple times where on my thing it says it's 100% A-OK. And did you answer mine about you saying that every time you come in here and I'm not hitchhiking? I did. I said you came in on a day where I'm not hitchhiking at all because I lost my internet device and I'm waiting for a new one to be delivered. And that's why I'm just chilling here in town. But yeah, a lot of hitchhiking isn't hitchhiking. It's walking, or it's eating, or it's figuring out what you're going to do, where you're going to go, where you're going to hitchhike from. Minority of this time is actually thumb on the road. Oh yeah, and I did see the Clutch Frog, the different Guinnesses. When you're in Ireland and you just ask for a pint of Guinness, is it the extra stout or is it the 7.5 one you got? Especially since you haven't seen each other for almost 3 weeks. That's a long time. It's really nice to wind down today with a couple beers. What were you eating? Fried green tomatoes. Same beer with the foreign ad in there. Still extra stout. You're getting that. Okay. That really sucks. Having your schedules not match up like that. Yeah, it's rough. This is like a light dinner for me. Yeah, have we determined, is this 4.3% or 7.5%? No, I'll just grab the bill if I could. Oh, right there. Perfect, thanks. So what's gonna happen after this? I was trying to get on a trolley tour, but I missed them today. The real guess is 7.5%. Oh. But I don't know what I'm drinking. Is it 4.3 or is it 7.5? I don't know. It's 6 in Georgia. That's right, Kazakhs. Plan after this is I'm just gonna walk back to my place. Anyway, I love this song. Set an open call for the emergency. Get to be free. Don't make fun of me. I know you're gonna make fun of me anyway, but that's okay. Free to face the life that's ahead of me. I know I'm the captain, so climb aboard. We'll search for tomorrow and every show. Yeah, I just like this song. Okay, Michael Bublé, I wish. Don't we all wish we could sing like Michael Bublé? No one talk crap about Michael Bublé. Guy has a voice of an angel. The sea. Reflections in the waves spark my memory. So, how do you feel about Nickelback? I think they're fine. I think people just enjoy making, like, ripping on Nickelback. I think some of their songs are good, some of their songs are bad. It's just like that, and like, you know, people like Justin Bieber and stuff like that too. Like, they're successful, and people, like, they enjoy just ripping on them. But they're successful. People like their music. You don't have to like their music, but they have their market, and they do well with it. They do very well with it. Saying that because he's Canadian? Never got that one? Like, yeah, I enjoy some of Nickelback's music. I do. You ever heard Nickelback play with Pantera? No. What day is it tomorrow? Is it June? Wait, this may have 31 days or 30? It's almost my birthday. 24. There's nothing special about 24. Not that there has to be. Is it June? 31. 31 days, I guess. Who the hell is Michael Bublé? How do you not know who Michael Bublé is? Something about a concert? They aren't the worst thing out there? I'm sure seeing their live concert would be fun. I would go to a Nickelback concert. I would. I don't think I'd pay $150 to go to a Nickelback concert. I'd pay $20 to go to a Nickelback concert. Working night tomorrow, that means don't have to go to bed now, or rather, you should. What time is it there? You must be in Sweden. Oh, is it 5 hours ahead? Western Europe is 8 hours ahead of Pacific time, and now I'm 3 hours ahead of Pacific time, so 5 hours ahead? 5 or 6 hours ahead? Eating in, all I had was some deep-fried tomatoes, or fried green tomatoes. It was just a light snack and a couple beer. Should go to One Direction concert? Honestly, they're so dreamy. Honestly, I think going to like almost any concert live is a good experience. It's fun. Even if you don't like the music that much, the experience of going to a live concert is such that it can make up for a music genre that you're not too much into. I would go to a One Direction concert. I don't feel bad saying that. We went to a Nickelback concert and they gave me a diamond refund.
It's
especially outdoor venues. You know, I've never been to a big outdoor venue. Like, I've been to a music festival before. That's an outdoor venue. We're being stared at? This is how I read chat. I stare at my device. Someone said that earlier, like, stop staring at us. I'm like, when you're talking to someone, you should stare at them. Like look at them, not stare at them. Oh, behind you. Oh. Working tomorrow night means you're off during the day. Maybe you should find something to do. Hitchhike. Go for a little peruse on the road with your thumb out. Yeah, hitchhike colostomy. I went like this. But to other people, it just looks like I'm going like this. I'm just pointing my finger up, but in a specific position. So unless they're looking at the screen, then it looks like I'm pointing. But if you're just like seeing me, it just looks like I'm putting my finger up, you know? Finger, thumb. Man, all these places have good music.
Have a good evening, okay? Perfect.
Yeah, you too.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks. Where are we eating? A tavern on River Street in Savannah, Georgia. What's the proper way to put your thumb up? As prominent as you can. You know? So like if you've got like a, I don't know, if you can't do it, like still get up as much as you can. But if you can like get it up there, get it up there. I don't have like the hitcher's thumb where the top joint like bends way back, but I have a long thumb. Gothenburg is the second largest city in Sweden. It would be hard to hitchhike here. That's true. Cities are difficult. Get out of town and probably turn again. Yeah. Like I went from Stockholm to Gothenburg. Was that southwest? And getting to Sweden, there's a free city bus from downtown to take you to IKEA. And I took that and I hitchhiked from IKEA and got to Gothenburg that way. See if there's a free city bus. Can you show up, fire your thumb buns backwards? Pretty far? I used to be able to touch the back of my thumb. Like I can touch it forward very easily. That's easy. All my fingers can touch too. But I used to be able to bend my thumb backwards and touch the back of my wrist. Buses and the on-street subway. I don't find the word for it now. It's more or less free for me in Gothenburg. So, yeah, you take city transit to the edge of town. Probably find an on-ramp onto. I forget what the highways are called in Sweden. Find an on-ramp out. The problem is you work that evening. Hitchhiking when you have to be somewhere is stressful. And you have to be somewhere for work later that day, which is stressful. Clutch. Trevor, look forward to cooking for you, bud. You have to go, need to go to your AA home group meeting. Good rest tonight. Well, I'm looking forward to you cooking for me as well. I'm looking forward to also me attempting to help a little bit, just a little bit. And we'll see you later. And hope you have a good time at your home group meeting. Then you turned your ankle? You just slow your shirt, please, ID? Yeah. Do you tip for alcohol or just for food?
I'm in a sit-down place, so I'll tip the standard 15-25%.
What's your favorite beer? I don't have one.
I just like trying new things.
But as Trout said, you could hitchhike to Uddevalla, which is where you grew up.
Oh, that would be a cool trip. You could probably do that pretty confidently round trip in one day and not have a problem.
And then bus or train?
Yeah.
And then the bus or the train would be a reliable form of transportation.
That'd be fun. You should do that. That'd be a fun day.
Do you have VAT in Canada? The country is increasing ours.
What's VAT?
Is that like a sales tax?
Okay.
Like an alcohol tax? We have sales tax in Canada. It varies province by province. The lowest is Alberta, where it's 5%. That's just federal tax. They have zero provincial tax. And the highest is like 15% in like, I think like Quebec and some maritime provinces. Value added tax. But is that just a sales tax? Assault Rabbit. Thanks for subscribing. Welcome to the Twitch Hackers. And thank you for the support. Thank you. Oh yeah. Can you guys like snap your my fingers just can like bend flat. Like my hand pancakes. You know? So. The train isn't that reliable? Oh. Train company in Sweden is already almost always late? 2 hours depending on what you go by depending... Oh, okay. Do you have bones now?
I gave up on bones years ago.
Can you stick your ring finger up there?
Like, that much.
I do have a long ring finger. Like, compared to my... Like, it's as long as my middle finger, pretty much. Yeah, maybe you do that tomorrow. We'll see. Might end up spending time with Jess. Wait, yeah, you just said that you don't get any time to spend with your girlfriend. Take the time. Be with your fiance. Be with your fiance. That's probably the best thing you could do. I was about to be all in. I'll be like, yeah, go hitchhike. But you said you haven't really spent time in 3 weeks. That's important. Your relationship is important. Quality time with your significant other is important. Alright. I'm finished. I'm paid. I'm going to start walking back home. Hopefully it doesn't rain on me. It might. If it does, that's okay. Alright, so everyone, are you prepared for the difference? So this is the stock camera, and then I add the wide-angle lens, because this is about an arm length from me right now. This is an arm length. Alright, what color are your eyes? Green. And this is with the wide-angle lens, at arm's length. It's a very large difference. What I like about this is I can
have this at arm's length walking down the street, and you can see a wide perspective of what's going on around me. Where when I have that off, it's just my face. My face right in your face. Alright. I'm ready to go. Are you ready to go? I'm ready to go. That was, people saying relationship counselor. I've done long distance relationships and they didn't work for me. I've had a few failed relationships because of my travels and what I do as a hobby. Distance is difficult on a relationship. Talk to some girls, man. That's not really what the goal of the trip is. I travel, I check out places, and I want to meet some people. It'd probably be off stream. Would you care with your girlfriend to hitchhike? Yeah. That was probably loud. That's probably loud. I'm using a lav mic today. Yeah. Like, if you want a live stream where they go around and try to pick up girls, you'll probably be able to find that, but that's not what I do here. My brother hearts. Yeah, my hobbies, my early, like, this whole training stuff has led to several relationships I haven't worked out. She's done so many sacrifices for one that. So she's awesome. Yeah, spend some time with her. Still the same stuff from last night? No, this is a different restaurant. But yeah, we're in the same city. Because I'm waiting for my internet service provider, my new one, to show up.
I'm not sure about it. You can crack jokes.
You too. Alright. Oh, it's raining a bit. Just a little bit. Looks very similar. Yeah, a few people have asked if that was the same place as last night. The inside decor is very similar. Very similar. Oh, the cat lady's there again. Restaurant there's owned by the same company. It's a very touristy spot. I went there for the beer, and then I saw that they. Let's walk this way rather than taking the same route I took yesterday evening. I went there because I wanted a beer to wind down, and beer is beer. But then yeah, I saw that they had the fried green tomatoes, and people were saying yeah, that's like a southern kind of thing. And it's in season and it's really good, and I tried it and it was really good. Kind of pricey, $9 for like five little circles of fried tomato. The markup on that is astronomical. How much does a tomato cost? Like 50 cents? 50 cents, a little bit of batter, a little bit of time deep frying it. Yeah, this whole area is really quite beautiful, the cobblestone. Some of these staircases are very, very old and weathered. It's pretty cool. Free if you grown it? Exactly. All it took was a little bit of time. The more unhealthy something is, the more it costs. Sometimes it costs more to eat healthy, unless you're like growing your own healthy stuff. But like it costs a whole lot more to shop at Whole Foods than it does to like grab a McDouble at McDonald's. Unhealthy, I think that's one of the reasons why obesity is kind of like a more common thing is the it's a lot easier and cheaper to eat unhealthy than it is to eat healthy. It's not easy to eat healthy. It's raining. Uh-oh. And you guys have seen that. Like, I eat out of convenience. When I'm on travel days, I'll eat fast food. I'll go grab a burger. That's not healthy food. It makes me feel full. Well, we're talking about food. Cigarettes are a separate issue. So your government's trying to kill you? Is this a conspiracy? No, I don't think it is. It's just most foods that are healthy aren't preserved. They're fresh foods. And fresh foods are more expensive to bring to market. And there's a whole lot more wasted because they go bad. A lot of the things that we consider bad foods are varying levels of non-perishable. I don't know which road I took. I don't know where I'm going. Where am I? I know I have to go this way a certain amount, and I have to go left at some point. Snickers says peanuts, that's healthy, exactly. The rain's much harder than this, then this probably isn't good for the phone. Right now it's probably just manageable. But chocolate and caramel? What about them? Are they healthy, you mean? Like a little bit of dark chocolate's fine for you. But like chocolate isn't really that great. You see that? I gave her a nod as she walked by. She looked a little scared of the camera, but I gave her some eye contact and a little nod, and she immediately nodded back. People can't resist the nod. It comes from a plant that must be healthy. I wish that were the case. A lot of things come from plants, but like if you just eat cocoa beans or like 99% dark chocolate, it's not really that bad for you. But what they add to chocolate to make it palatable, a whole lot of sugar and other things. A nod is so much better than an ignore. Exactly. A nod is like a sign of, I see you and I respect you, but I'm just going to keep on carrying on with my day. Who am I hating on? Or what am I hating on? Marlies. Welcome back. It's all about how much you consume in your body. Yeah. Moderation. Pretty much anything. Are these eucalyptus trees or whatever you call them? That's strange. I don't think I've seen these trees. Yeah, things in moderation. Yep, no bag today, just the little bag, which is glorious. It feels amazing. Meme is it says boots. I know. This is conclusive evidence that it is in fact my backpack. I'm wearing a different backpack. Do you hear any squeak? Is there any squeak? Do you hear a squeak? I don't think you do. I don't think you do. Well, we found our way back to the graveyard. Now, what we learned from yesterday is that you walk a certain enough this direction, and all of a sudden things become a little bit sketchy. And then they become fine again, then they become sketchy again, then become fine again, and then sketchy again, and then fine again, and then sketchy again, and then fine again, and then sketchy again. You hear my pants. Why'd you walk around the city without boots? My new backpack? It's not a new backpack. It's my backup backpack. It's my day pack. So when I don't have to carry my huge backpack, I have a little backpack where I can carry a few essentials if I need them. Like I have a spare battery. I have my other microphone if I had an opportunity to use that microphone, but I didn't. I have some Snickers. Like the essentials. Snickers and batteries. So this cemetery is from like 1792. And the most recent burials, I think, were like 1850-something, 1853, 1856. So everything here is 150-plus years old. So you keep a backpack in a backpack? Normally, like, if you look at my backpack, I have this backpack actually hanging off the back of the backpack. So the backpack is on the backpack. The backpack is riding the other backpack. So it's not, is it inception or like, is it just this one backpack is a parasite? Yo, Doug, I heard you like backpacks, so we got this backpack for your backpack. And yeah, it is like a backpack pack, or because it's a backpack on the back of my backpack. You hear people are dying to get into that place? Well, people haven't died to get into this place since 1853. So, this is old news. Uh-oh. Pretty graveyard, and then... is this sketchy area coming up? I don't know. See, that's the problem. Like, a lot of cities are mostly fine, but then you'll get areas where they're not fine. Uh-oh, it's raining. Uh-oh. But I don't know that. I don't know where the good and the bad are. Luckily, it's still daytime, so it should be fine regardless, but... church over there.
What are y'all looking for?
Fox and pig.
Let's go this way. Mm-hmm. Stay safe. I'm always safe. Homework. A couple nights ago, I had like a dream where like I had an exam or something like that, and I wasn't studying. And everyone's like, "Oh, you didn't study for that? What are you doing? This is a difficult one." And then I woke up and I'm like, "Trevor, you haven't been to school for over 4 years. It's okay. You'll be all right. You don't have to study for anything. You're a hitchhiker. You literally don't have to know too much. You just kind of stand on the road with your thumb out. Everything will be all right." Guy with the khaki shorts and golf shirt walking. No, but he's apparently got game. There are these two girls walking, and they're looking at a phone and kind of walking and looking around, and he's like, "Where are you guys heading?" And they're like, "This place." And he's like, just wave them over, and now they're walking together. Gotta study for the impact exam. I know, he's always like, "Trevor, figure out Lexbox." And then I just stare at him blankly. "Trevor, do anything on the background." And then I stare at him blankly. Even though I'm not live streaming and I can't even stare at him, I still stare in the direction of Toronto, Canada, where he's from, blankly. I'm like, "Impact. I don't know how to do that." Hardcore, you've heard the impact exam? Yeah, he asks you like questions like, you know, really tough stuff, like, "How do you set up Lexbox?" And I just stare at him blankly. It just doesn't work. Say his name two more times and put it to the test. I don't know if I need to summon him right now. It's dangerous to summon him too many times. He'll get angry. You haven't seen Impact angry. It's dangerous. It's really violent. Really hurt. Says hurtful things. Like lol. And other things that hurt my feelings. Russell Stream wakes up in a tent in the middle of nowhere at 3 a.m. and feels relief. That's exactly it. Like, if I have a dream like that and I wake up and I'm in the middle of the woods, on the outskirts of some city somewhere in the middle of nowhere, somewhere where I've never been, I'm like, "Oh, thank God I'm in the middle of nowhere, where I don't know where I am. I was worried there for a second that I actually had to do something productive with my life." Hold up. Wait, Impact showed up? Maybe I did say it 3 times. Oh. He's here. Shh, everyone be quiet. I have to look at a map. I don't know where I am. Where am I? I don't even know anymore. Yes, we go right on the street and then we go for a long time. Perfect. Not a long time. Just a good time. I think I want to be on the left side of the street though. Don't click your heel. Might be back in Kansas, but you guys know, I told you about Kansas. I met some of the nicest people in the world in Kansas. If I can click my heels 3 times and go back to Cal and Kim's place, I will absolutely do that.
Wait.
I'll get some like home-cooked meals, some home-cooked dessert. Maybe I'll like oil my boots again. We'll go play with some horses. It'd be wonderful. It would be wonderful. Wait, I should have taken that trolley system. It's that free tram thing. Oh well. Because it's here and go back, goes to Canada. Then maybe they won't let me back into America. Wait. Walk sign is on. Wait. Stop telling me what to do. My bad side of town senses are tingling. This is a good part of town. I can tell. But yeah, I was a little bit on edge walking around New Orleans because like I got dropped off near the hospital. I wanted to check out the homeless shelter because the guy that drove me there said it was a dry shelter, so like people wouldn't be like drinking or doing drugs in there, and I'm like, oh, that's cool, let's go check it out. So I checked it out. I walked around the corner to like the street where it was on, and there was someone shooting up right in front of me. I'm like, oh, all right, let's not go to the homeless shelter. That was a bad idea. Let's just go, like, you know, to the French Quarter and do normal touristy things. But I had to walk underneath the interstate to get there, and I'm walking across the interstate like underneath, and that's where the tent city is. That's where all the homeless people set up their tents at night. I'm like walking underneath the bridge, and there's like these guys standing there, just, you know, nonchalantly. I'm walking up there, and then like someone walks up, and like a big, quick cash transaction happens. You know, some money exchanges hands, some goods exchange hands. I'm like, oh, that's probably an illegal, you know, transaction of some sort. And then I'm like, okay, yeah, people told me to not camp in New Orleans. It's probably a good idea. It's probably a good idea to not camp in New Orleans. Are we F? Yeah, it was a nonchalant, illegal deal of some sorts. Honestly, I couldn't actually... It could have been just, you know, like, they could have sold something off of Craigslist. They could have just really quickly slipped them, like, I don't know, a phone or maybe some Pokemon cards. And they, like, gave them their Pokemon cards and they gave them cash and it was great. How many states have you visited so far? 19. Isn't Savannah in Africa? Yeah, I'm in Africa right now. Maybe magic cards? I think it was Pokemon cards. Those two homeless people met under the interstate among Tent City to exchange Pokemon cards. Exactly. They're probably like, you know, if you watch Pokemon, they're like one of the bad trainers, you know? Need you, internet. Saved? Okay. Like, we're probably getting to the tail end of my Canadian data, but I'm not sure when we're gonna run out. It could just, like, be like, game over, man. Game over. And we'll have no warning. Or we might have warning. Who knows? Get some dinner yet? Kind of. I had a very, very late breakfast, lunch, and possibly dinner. And I had a dinner that consisted of some fried green tomatoes and beer. But I had a Guinness, so that's a meal. Data is done. Save some data for tomorrow. Well, hopefully I'll get my delivery pretty early and I'll be able to switch on to Verizon. Mic is annoying? What's the mic doing? Is the mic making weird noises? Is it like bouncing off something and making noise? Slight oofing from mic crackles. Interesting, maybe there's some water's gotten in there or some
Something or other.
Rip. Now we're ripping. Oh god. Sounds like campfire about to skate now. Snap crackle pop. Alright, well I switched it to my shirt. It might have just been cord might have been bouncing off something and like been making some noise. Alright. Fixed. On the fly, troubleshooting my audio. We did it. I haven't used this lav mic before. It's been in my bag the whole time. I just haven't used it. Alright, so I think I'm going to do like a wind down stream inside my Airbnb, but as I walk the final block to my Airbnb, I'm gonna scuff the video. Switch to my map and see where I am in relation to where I gotta go. Where am I? Excuse me, phone, where am I? Phone. Still got a little bit. Why did you decide on Savannah to stay for a couple days? Because I lost my internet provider, my Jetpack, the thing that provides the internet to run the live stream on, just outside of Savannah. And I'm like, all right, we'll go there. People have told me Savannah's a beautiful city, and we'll wait. I'll get the new internet as fast as I can, but we'll just wait there until it comes. New internet. Hopefully this one works. The first Jetpack I received from them was it didn't work very well. It would work usually okay in like decent areas, but if we went to a low connection area and back to a good connection area, it would never register that we've reconnected to a good area. So I'd have to reset the whole thing, and it just kind of sucked. And there's a few other problems with it, and my internet service provider is like, yeah, that's a faulty unit. So they sent me a brand new one. You know what I did with the brand new one? I left it in a frickin' truck. So hopefully the next one I get is also a new one, and it's also without any kind of problems. Because the last one was actually working really well for me. I was really happy with how the internet was going. And then I left it in a truck. Give it away to the trucker. Yeah, it was a gift. Here you go, trucker. Present. What? No, I left it in a truck yesterday. And I'm waiting for a new one to come. I haven't been in a truck since the first time I left a Jetpack in a truck. Okay. So these buttons are back to normal. So if you want to cross this way, it has an arrow. and it's kind of like you cross that way. The ones in Florida, this one wouldn't tell you, wouldn't have an arrow, but it would say push button to cross this street, and it would be to cross that street. Technically paid for the ride. Worst hitchhiker ever. Oh no, what have I done? Have you mowed someone's lawn yet? Are you calling me Forrest Gump? Calling me Forrest Gump. He's a really nice fellow. Trucker probably never use it. That's true. The trucker probably never even saw it. Probably fell out of his bag or out of my bag, and he's like, I don't know. What is this? I don't know. Maybe he did find it, but chances are he never found it. It's just underneath the seat somewhere or something. I'm in your old hometown. Nice. You remember this place? You're almost home? Buildings. You're not sure if you were walking? Yeah, sure, he ran everywhere. F? Mine says it's okay, are we okay? Saved. Heart, your network errors here, but it's a soft F. We're oofing and lowercase effing. Yesterday it was fine here. Today it's not fine. EMPs, oh no. Damn EMPs. Yeah. All the biggest heist jobs involve an EMP. They did that in Ocean's 11, didn't they? They had to use an EMP to rob a Las Vegas casino. You gonna take me and my 204 of your friends back to the Airbnb? Yeah, exactly. But I'm going to hide the location of that Airbnb because you are not to be trusted. Down the funds for an EMP? Dang it, guys. What did I pay you for? Oh, that's right, I don't pay you. Are you just randomly walking? No, I'm walking to where where my home is for the night. It's a little Airbnb. Sign says do not enter. Wrong way. Turn around. Did I walk past the street? I don't know if I did. How does everyone know where my Airbnb is? Stop knowing. Stop it. I think you guys know where I stay. I don't trust you guys. I'm gonna keep going. You missed house? You're reading a science strip. Well, whatever. I'm going to this cross section, and if it looks like I've gone too far, then I'll turn around. The sign said wrong way. Oh. You trust me. The mods are the biggest trolls. Mods are supposed to help me, but they just trolled me. Ah, yes, I know where we are. I know where we are. We're going right, and I'm gonna... Oops. Going right. it might stop being frozen. Thank you. All right. Scuff the stream. Should do a mod purge? Yeah, I'm getting rid of all the mods, and we're gonna run without mods for a while, just to see how that goes. Turn left, no, I'm going right. You can't be out tonight? No, I have an Airbnb. Thanks, Neon Trail. I made the screen black for a reason. Is that bad for Wi-Fi? It apparently is. Albeit, I bet if I had Verizon and my antenna, it would have been fine. I could have probably run the stream today mostly in HD. No, I'm hiding the stream so you don't know where I'm sleeping. Stop with the effing. Stop. Stop. Almost home. And I'll switch over to Wi-Fi and blah 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 blah. Everything will be dandy. The world is, everything is right in the world. And yeah. Streamlabs, don't be a rude dude. Ugh. I'll have to switch to the Wi-Fi anyway, so let's just